We gather this morning in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And you may be seated. The words from Psalms 130. Out of the depths I have cried to you, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. Let your ears be attentive to the voice of my supplications. If you, Lord, should mark iniquities, O Lord, who could stand? But there is forgiveness with you that you may be feared. I wait for the Lord. My soul does wait, and in his word do I hope. My soul waits for the Lord more than the watchman for the morning. Indeed, more than the watchman for the morning. O Israel, hope in the Lord. For with the Lord there is loving kindness, and with him is abundant redemption, and he will redeem Israel from all his iniquities. Would you pray with me? Almighty and everlasting God, you have brought us the gift of eternal life through the death of your Son. You have made the grave a holy place for your faithful people and made it to be a peaceful resting place until we all hear the trumpet's call on the last day. Help us to be mindful that our time on earth is short and that we must always be ready to meet you. May we live in true penitence over our sin and by faith trust in your unfailing promises that our sins are forgiven for the sake of Jesus Christ. Grant that we, with all who truly love you, may join you in the resurrection of the dead. We pray this through Jesus Christ, your dear Son and our Lord. Amen. For our scripture readings this morning, let us hear what Jesus says about death and judgment. In Psalms 90, the psalmist says, "Before the mountains were born, or you gave birth to the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. You turn man back into dust and say, 'Return, O children of men.' For 1,000 years in your sight are like yesterday when it passes by, or as a watch in the night. You have swept them away like a flood, and they fall asleep. And in the morning, they are like grass, which sprouts anew. In the morning, it flourishes and it sprouts anew. And towards evening, it fades and withers away. So teach us to number our days, that we may present to you a heart of wisdom." And in the New Testament, we read from Romans chapter 5, "Therefore, just as through one man sin entered into the world, and death through sin, and so death spread to all men, because all have sinned." And the writer of Hebrews said in chapter 9, "And inasmuch as it is appointed for men to die once, and after this comes the judgment." Let us hear what our Lord Jesus said concerning the watchful care that he desires to find us in. In Luke chapter 15, he says, be dressed in readiness and keep your lamps lit. Be like men who are waiting for their master when he returns from the wedding feast, so that they may immediately open the door to him when he comes and he knocks. Blessed are those slaves whom the master will find on the alert when he comes. Truly, I say to you that he will gird himself to serve and have them recline at the table and will come up and wait on them. You too be ready, for the Son of Man is coming in an hour in which you do not expect. And finally, let us hear from scriptures concerning the resurrection and everlasting life. In John chapter 11, Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live even if he dies. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" And Paul wrote in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, "Behold, I tell you a mystery. We will not all sleep, but we will all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised imperishable, and we will all be changed. For this perishable must put on imperishable, and this mortal must put on immortality. But when this perishable will have put on imperishable, and when this mortal will have put on immortality, then will come about the saying that is written, 'Death is swallowed up in victory.' O death, where is your victory? O death, where is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God who gives us victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Here ends our scripture reading. And one of the songs that Marian had requested is Come Christians Join to Sing. Marian also requested the 23rd Psalms. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, and my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And your obituary is printed in your handout this morning. Marian L. Borstad was born on May 9th, 1927 in Brookings County, South Dakota. The daughter of Chris and Lizzie Borstad, Marian spent her early years in rural Bruce, South Dakota, and received her elementary education in Eureka District Number 56, and was a graduate of the Bruce High School in 1944. After receiving her education, she worked at South Dakota State University, Fenn Brothers in Sioux Falls, South Dakota, Augsburg Publishing House and Bemis Company in Minneapolis, Minnesota, and returned to South Dakota in 1971. She was employed at SDSU from 1977, most recently as a secretary of the Nutrition and Food Sciences Department until her retirement in 1992. She was a member of Grace Free Lutheran Church in Bruce, Ruth Circle, and the Women's Missionary Federation. She enjoyed reading, gardening, and spent many hours visiting people in various nursing homes. At the age of 96, Marian L. Borstad passed away at the United Living Community, where she had resided the last 10 years, on Saturday, March 16, 2024. Marian is survived by 11 nieces, Barb, Rosie, Bev, Muriel, Peggy, Marilyn, Donna, Diane, Cheryl, Sandra, and Carol. 8 nephews, Merv, Ron, Ted, Don, Larry, Gary, Robert, and Michael. and many other cousins and friends. She was preceded in death by her parents, 8 brothers, and 4 sisters. God bless her memory. And this was a song that when I was at the nursing home some time ago, I think this was on the radio when I came into her room, and she said this is one of her favorite songs, Love Lifted Me.
I was sinking deep in sin, far from the peaceful shore, very deeply stained within, sinking to rise no more. But the master of the sea heard my despairing cry, from the waters lifted me, now safe am I. Love lifted me, love lifted me, when nothing else could help, love lifted me. Love lifted me, love lifted me, when nothing else could help, love lifted me. All my heart to him I give, ever to him I'll cling, in his blessed presence live, ever his praises sing. Love so mighty and so true merits my soul's best songs. Faithful love and service to him belongs. Love lifted me, love lifted me, when nothing else could help, love lifted me, love lifted me, love lifted me, when nothing else could help, love lifted me. Love lifted me, love lifted me, when nothing else could help, love lifted me, love lifted me, love lifted me, when nothing else could help, love lifted me.
After the service today, we'll be going out to St. Petri for the burial, and then we'll be coming back for the lunch following the burial. Family and friends of Marion, we come alongside of you this morning to mourn the loss of Marion, but we also celebrate life today. We celebrate the long life of Marion and the purpose and the promise of eternal life for all who are called, all who believe by the Holy Spirit and confess their sins and know that Jesus is Lord. Today we worship Christ Jesus, who is the way, the truth, and the life. In him we have the blessed assurance of salvation that is ours and it can never be taken away. Some time ago, Marion had told me that that was one of her favorite songs, and it stuck with me because some of my favorite verses are from 1 John chapter 4, verses 7 and 8. And they say, "Beloved, let us love one another, for love is from God, and whoever loves has been born of God and knows God. And anyone who does not love does not know God, because God is love." What a reminder for us today that we are lifted up, that we are encouraged and strengthened because we know God. And because we know God, we know love. This morning, we're going to consider this love God had for us as it was shown to us in God the Son, Jesus Christ. We ponder our own mortality when we say goodbye to a loved one. Even so, with Marion, we rejoice. We rejoice at the length of life, all the days that she was blessed with. And we consider the blessings that God gives to each one of us in this life. Christians rejoice, even in hard times, because we know the love of God. Christians have comfort on a day like today, knowing of the salvation that is ours in Christ Jesus. When we are born again of God, we have that promise of the life everlasting. So I ask this morning, do you know Jesus as Lord and Savior? As we come here to worship, we come to the sanctuary of God, not built by the hands of men who put up this structure, but the love that God showed in the three nails that held Jesus on the cross. God the Son, there on the cross on Calvary's mountain, stayed because he loved us, because he loved Marian. We come to worship the God of our salvation, and we do so knowing that he is here with us today. The God who heard and continues to hear the cries for forgiveness from his children. And in his mercy, God came at just the right time as God the Son. This upcoming week now, we will be celebrating Passion Week. And we see the love God had for us as Jesus is steadfast as he goes to the cross for Marian's sins and for your sins and for the sins of the whole world. Yes, Jesus was the only payment possible for the salvation of sinners because we could not make it. Because of Good Friday, because of the resurrection on Easter Sunday, today we have the biblical hope of the resurrection. The Apostle John, who wrote 1 John, is well known as the disciple of love. I didn't get to know Marian all that well as over the years that I went and saw her, but I knew she had a good sense of humor. She would often tell me that she couldn't make it to church anymore because it was too far to walk. So I don't know if she used to walk when she lived in town to come to church, but she knew it was too far to walk. She would tell me of when she left Minnesota and she came back to Bruce to help her mom. And she would talk of her mom's smile. And as long as I've known her, there in her room was the picture of St. Petri Church. She loved her church. And I believe she loved her Lord. Marian would share of that beautiful smile and how I long to see the smile on faces of those who know Jesus as their Lord and as their Savior. But still, the smile like Marian's mom had and all of those who joyfully believe on this earth, that smile is going to be dim compared to what we will see in heaven. The radiant smiles of those who are glorified in the throne room of God. I think of her story so often when I think about the love of God and his smile that I believe is upon his face when one lost sinner comes to know him. God must just be beaming, right? Just smiling because of that lost sinner who knows Jesus. There are so many in the world today who don't know Jesus. And in the darkness of sin, they continue to hide and they have no place to find peace or to abide because they've been running from thing to thing, hiding from place to place. How they need to live in the comfort of his love. God uses 1 John 4, verses 17 and 18 to say this. He says, by this is the love perfected in us, so that we may have confidence on the day of judgment. Because as he is, so also are we in this world. There is no fear in love, because perfect love casts out fear. Because fear has to do with punishment. And whoever fears has not been perfected in love. Here ends that reading. How we need to abide in God's love and to not have fear. Not to have fear what will happen to us and having no fear of where we will spend eternity because of that great and perfect love which he has given to us. His love which continues to comfort each one of you today as you mourn the loss of a loved one. God's love is what enables you, even when you don't want to admit to say it, to see that you are a sinner. And that in that love, God had a plan to save you. God had a plan to save Marian. God has a plan for each and every one of us. It's in his love which we begin to see the need for salvation, to start to ask for forgiveness for our sins, and that we would be prepared, sanctified, that we'd be led is what that word means, that we would be led forward to the day when we are glorified, when we will be in his presence. God's love reminds us of his grace and his mercy, and it was revealed in Christ Jesus. He who gave his life on Calvary's cross, and then he rose up again in victory. Friends and family, I want to assure you the need of each and every one of us to have Jesus in our hearts and in our lives. You may be listening to the world which attempts to remove us from every confidence in Jesus and tries to replace it with stuff and idols, but all of that will leave you angry, it will leave you hurt, and it will leave you empty. Today, the truth and the life still is Christ Jesus, our Lord and Savior, and in Him alone. My prayer for all of us is for the awareness of God's constant love, that it never stops, that constant love that He has for us. Believers in Christ, we are family. I think of the smiles to be brought to the faces of those around who come to see Jesus as Savior, and when we listen to the Holy Spirit, and when we are strengthened to confess our sins, oh, the Holy Spirit will give us joy and confidence and peace in our Lord Jesus Christ. And in this, we get to come home to our family. No matter who they are, no matter where they are, when we come into Christ's presence, when we come into His church, when we share the love of Jesus, we say, welcome home. Welcome home. God's love is perfected in us. God's love is perfected in each and every one of you. Even if today you are struggling to accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, He's still your Lord, and He still loves you. And in your world, you may be trying to cover over the hurt. You maybe don't have peace. You may be trying to achieve the next great thing. But you might still be thinking, where will I spend eternity? Put your faith, put your hope in Jesus Christ. And in Him you will know and you will have certainty of Christ Jesus. This morning, I encourage you to consider John's words for us and to see the need to ask for help from God who created you and the God who loves you even still today. If you are sad or if you're disappointed, I encourage you to think about this song that Marion liked so much. Love lifted me. When nothing else would help, God's love lifted me. In this song is the reflection brought on only by the Holy Spirit. When I was sinking deep in sin, that's the Holy Spirit's work. Look what's going on in your life. Hey, did you see that? Hey, did you realize? And then love lifted me. When we think about all and all where we might spend eternity, how we need Jesus, because we see we've been sinking deep in sin. But today, the solution is simple. Christ Jesus. Is He your Lord and Savior? Because Christ Jesus' love lifts you up. The love of God by sending Him at just the right time. That He reached out His hand and He, Christ Himself, has pulled you up. And now we abide in Him. The promises that He had and will continue to abide in you. If you all have confidence in this because of Christ Jesus, you are robed in His righteousness. And we have no fear. And then John says that perfect love casts out fear. This upcoming week, this Passion Week, good Monday, Thursday, Good Friday, Easter, may we see that perfect love as Jesus is lifted up, nailed to that cross, and in that empty tomb 3 days later, His love is perfected in victory. Brothers and sisters, I want there to be no fear. For John says that those who have fear have not been perfected in love. May today we all be perfected in His love. May today be the day where we give up on the lies of this world and believe in the truth that is God's holy word. May you realize that your sin debt was paid in full by faith, by grace, by the word of God. And love has and will continue to lift us up. When nothing else has helped, the love of God lifts you up. Your sin debt is no more because of Christ Jesus. Sin debt was paid for Marion as she trusted in the Lord and as she confessed her sins. It was paid for all who believe. He made the payment on the cross and God accepted it. Would you let the Holy Spirit apply that to your hearts today? And will you share your faith and your love of Jesus with others and share your confidence in him? Because on the day when you are called home, at the day of your funeral, your friends and family will be able to rejoice in knowing the faith that you had in that completed payment. What joy there is for your family. Don't be stubborn. Brothers and sisters, trust in the Lord. Don't deny the Lord before others. Seek him. Be found by the God of your salvation and tell others of your love. Let his love lift you up. Blessed be the memory of Marian, and praise be to the God of our Father, Lord Jesus Christ, for the gift of grace and the mercy that he bestows upon all who believe. Would you pray with me? Almighty and everlasting God, because of your sin, we must die and be returned to the ground. So teach us to number our days that we may gain a heart of wisdom. Grant us a true faith in your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, he who was delivered for our offenses and raised again for our justification and reigns to all eternity. Help us by your grace that we may die daily unto sin and live according to your holy will, so that when the hour of death shall come, we may be prepared through faith in your word for a peaceful departure. Receive our souls unto yourself and grant that at the last day our bodies may rise again from the grave unto everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And receive the benediction from Hebrews chapter 13. Now may the God of peace, who brought up from the dead the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the eternal covenant, even Jesus our Lord, equip you for every good thing to do his will, working in us that which is pleasing in his sight through Jesus Christ, to whom be the glory forever and ever. Amen. And our closing hymn was another one that Marian had requested, When Peace Like a River.
When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot thou hast taught me to say, it is well, it is well with my soul. It is well with my soul. It is well, it is well with my soul. Oh, Satan should buffet, though trial should come, let this last assurance control, that Christ hath regarded my helpless estate, and has shed soul. It is well with my soul. It is well, it is well with my soul. my sin, not in part, but the whole. His nail to his cross, and I bear it no more. Praise the Lord, praise the Oh,